Good morning, CityView kids and parents. I'm your host, Jeremy. Thanks for tuning in to the CityView Kids live stream. In just a second, we'll get to watch our weekly kids program. Pastor Travis will teach us a story from the Bible, and Mrs. Heather will lead us in a craft. Visit the link below for lesson resources and more. Get ready to have fun and stay tuned. Hey guys, I'm so glad to have you back. Today, we're going to learn about Jesus being a good shepherd. Jesus came to earth to do his Father's plan. He came to rescue sinners. Jesus also taught people about God. Let me ask you a question. What did Jesus teach when he was on earth? Jesus taught about God and his kingdom. He taught that all scripture is about him. Well, today's Bible story is called The Good Shepherd. Let's find out how Jesus is the Good Shepherd and how we are like sheep. Watch the video with me.
Jesus told a story to the Jewish leaders. If a person climbs into a sheep pen, he is not the shepherd, he is a thief. A shepherd enters the pen through the gate. When the sheep hear the shepherd's voice, they recognize him and follow him. A shepherd calls his sheep by name and he leads them. If the sheep hear the voice of a stranger, they will run away. The people did not understand Jesus' story. Jesus was talking about God's people as sheep. The Jewish leaders were the stranger, and Jesus is the shepherd. Jesus said, "I am the gate for the sheep. They come in through me and are saved." Jesus was saying that he is the gate that leads to true life. People who come to him are like sheep who come to green pastures. Jesus warned, "A thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy." Jesus was talking about the devil, who does not want people to follow God. Jesus said, "I have come so that they may have life. I am the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep," Jesus said. "I know my sheep, and my sheep know me." Like a shepherd risks his own life to protect his sheep from wolves, Jesus was willing to die for his people. Jesus came to do his Father's plan, and he was going to die and rise again. The Jews argued with one another. Many said, "Don't listen to him. He has a demon. He's crazy." Others said, "That's not true. How can a demon give sight to the blind?" The Jewish leaders asked Jesus, "Are you really the Messiah? Just tell us." Jesus answered, "I did tell you, but you did not believe because you are not my sheep. My miracles prove who I am." Jesus reminded them that he is the good shepherd. "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. The Father and I are one." Jesus is the good shepherd. God sent him to rescue sinners. Jesus laid down his life for his sheep so they could have forgiveness and eternal life. When we trust in Jesus, we are his sheep who listen to, follow, and obey him.
In Bible times, shepherding was a common occupation. Leaders of nations, even non-Israelite nations, would refer to themselves as shepherds of the people. A good shepherd would guide, provide for, and protect his people. Yet Old Testament prophets like Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Ezekiel criticized Israel's leaders for failing to shepherd God's people well. The Israelites were like sheep, helpless and wandering, and they longed for a truly good shepherd. Jesus is the good shepherd who provides abundant life for his sheep. A shepherd would gather his sheep at night and form a pen to keep the sheep in and to keep wild animals and thieves out. The shepherd would lay across the opening like a shepherd provides safety for his sheep. Jesus provides salvation and eternal life. Jesus is the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep. A shepherd protects his sheep from wolves and other wild animals, even at risk to his own life. Jesus gave up his life on the cross to rescue sinners from sin and death. Finally, Jesus is the good shepherd who knows his sheep. Even when two or more flocks gather in a pen, a shepherd could call for his sheep and they would respond to the sound of his voice. Jesus knows his sheep personally. One fact about sheep is that they are directionally challenged. The poor things couldn't find a direction back home. If they wandered off from the flock and shepherd, it's hard, if not impossible, for them to get back on their own. The shepherd has to come and find them. Jesus shares a story about this very thing happening in Luke 15:4-7. It says, if a man has 100 sheep and one of them gets lost, what will he do? Won't he leave the 99 others in the wilderness and go to search one that he lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he will joyfully carry it home on his shoulders. When he arrives, he will call together his friends and neighbors, saying, rejoice with me because I have found my lost sheep. In the same way, there is more joy in heaven over one lost sinner who repents and returns to God than over 99 others who are righteous and haven't strayed away. This is what our good shepherd, Jesus, does with us when we start to wander away from him. He comes after us and carries us back to the fold, and then he celebrates that we are back in right relationship with him. Jesus isn't walking the earth as a human today, but God gives believers his Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit reminds us what is true. He helps us and guides us as we live on earth, waiting for the day Jesus will return and set up his kingdom forever. Jesus, the Good Shepherd, came to do his Father's plan, to die on the cross, to rise again so that we might be saved. We can live sacrificially as we point others to the sacrifice Jesus made for us. Today we are going to close in prayer in a slightly different way. I'm going to read Psalm 23, which is a song that praises God for being our good shepherd and tells us of the great things he has done for us. So bow your heads while we praise God and listen. The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. He lets me rest in green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. He renews my strength. He guides me along right paths, bringing honor to his name. Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid, for you are close beside me. Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me. You prepare a feast for me in the presence of my enemies. You honor me by anointing my head with oil. My cup overflows with blessings. Surely your goodness and unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will live in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. All right, let's get ready for another fun graph with Miss Heather.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Miss Heather. Thank you, Travis, for that wonderful message. We are going to get started with the craft now. What you're going to need are some crayons and glue, scissors, and some paint, preferably white paint if you have it, because we are going to make a sheep today. And then you're going to need some construction paper. I have blue for the sky, and then I already cut out my sheep, my little sheep face and my little sheep feet, and then we're gonna do some finger painting with it. So let's get started. All right, so first off, do some eyes, put some glue so that the face can go down. I want his face to be kind of goofy, so I'm doing it sideways. Press down, and then you're gonna make some eyes, and I want to make a smiley face too. And then the feet, I'm going to make those kind of goofy too. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint my thumb white, and I want you to get as much paint as you can on it because you're going to want to do multiple fingerprints as you go. And then you'll just reapply. And then you can just start doing a few here and there. And then, of course, you're going to run out. So you got to reapply. Have fun with it. Make it a goofy or a fluffy sheep. Now, about our Bible study, we learned about Jesus being our shepherd. So I thought a sheep craft would be fun to do. And if you want to make it even more fun, you can use your glue and glue some cotton balls around the sheep as well to make him just even more fluffy. That could be fun. Whatever you have at home, you can use. If you don't have white paint, that would work too. All right. Almost done. And we are done with the paint, but what I'm gonna do now is just draw some grass. All right, and I'm gonna name him Stanley. Stanley the sheep. All right, thanks everyone for doing the craft with me. I hope you had a good time and a great Sunday with your family. We're gonna sing now, so get up on your feet. We're gonna sing, dance together, have some fun with it, okay? Bye!
Thanks again to Pastor Travis and Mrs. Heather for the awesome kids program this week. We're going to end the stream here, so tune back in at 10 o'clock for CityView Worship. See you then.